Miller chasing a hat-trick of wins in 2021. He's already fought himself right back into championship contention after the vultures were circling early doors after a pretty disappointing start to his factory Ducati career. He comes to their home Grand Prix, feeling like he can walk on water right now. Jack Miller, winner in Jerez, winner in Le Mans. Is he about to top the timesheets here in this second practice session? But at the moment, six. He's only going one way, P1. It's going to be tight, not a lot of time to play with as he comes through the final corner.
Tardozzi's heart rate still pretty flat at the moment. Not too excited, if he's pleased at what he's seeing. And across the line, Miller will go to fourth. He lost a tenth in the final sector.
I would like to have seen Tardozzi's heart rate when they put Andrea Dovizioso on the screen at the side of the track. There might have been a little bit of a spike there.
All steady so far, though, as Mir, again, he'll lose a touch of time in that final sector and does a tenth and a half. It's close here, pretty close stuff in MotoGP as ever. 0.2 seconds, fifth place for Juan Mir. Here's Nakagami. This could be a lap that puts him up into top six contention. Ninth, in fact, 0.4 now covering the top nine riders.
Yeah, Nakagami flying the HRC flag yet again. He's their quickest man. Seventh fastest. A quick check on Pol Espargaró. He's down in 12th place at the moment. 1.1 seconds back in this session. And then the Marquez brothers, you've got to go a long, long way down to find them. Alex Marquez, of course, loves Mugello. Moto2 winner here a couple of years ago in 2019. Now Marc Marquez has slipped back to 20th.
Franco Morbidelli is at the moment in Q2, courtesy of his time from this morning. It's actually 15th quickest in this session. He's now entering pit lane with 3 minutes to go, so that could be end of session for Morbidelli.
This is a shame for Juan Mir because he was on a really, really good lap. Fabio Quartararo, as he so often does. Watch this young man go when you give him a brand new soft Michelin rear tyre, because normally it's super impressive and super fast.
No, he's upset. There's so much traffic up ahead, Matt, yeah, and he's furious about it.
Who's incurring the wrath then of Fabio Quartararo? Because at that stage of that lap, both Maverick Vinales and Quartararo, the two Monster Energy Yamaha men, were on monster fast lap times as well.
Oliveira here, he's fastest already with a 46.5. This won't be far away from matching it with a brand new soft rear in. Across the line he goes, very close, 600ths off his personal best. There is Maverick Vinales' side of the garage. He's also had to sit up and out of it because there were so many riders parked up, sat up over at Corentayo on the approach two.
Yeah, I wonder if that's what happened as well to Mir, Steve, because he was also on a very good lap on the Suzuki, and all of a sudden we saw him on board just sitting up and cruising.
Just get two laps in here, Maverick Vinales, but at the moment he's in second anyway. Brad Binder's just improved his time. He's up to 13th in this session. 14th overall, he's up in the first two sectors. Brad Binder's on an absolute flying lap. Number 33, he's almost 0.2 seconds up. And again, there's a trio of riders cruising here in Mugello.
Yeah, Quartararo's having to pick his way through some very heavy traffic right now. The marshals with the blue flags will be getting very, very busy.
Rins and Binder at the moment are the riders to keep an eye on with brand new soft rear tyres on. Here comes Rins first of all. He comes across the line and goes fastest with a 46.218 on the Suzuki. But where's Brad Binder, Matt? He must be coming out of the final corner.
Yeah, this will be a big lift for Binder as well. Can he get himself inside that top six or better? Over the line he comes, it is better. It's second, 146.436. Rins, Binder and Oliveira, the two factory KTMs, are inside the top three now, with Oliveira third.
Here comes Fabio Quartararo. He'll be hoping that there's no more traffic to get in his way. He's ninth at the moment. It's a pretty good lap he's putting together here. He's only 0.02 seconds down.
At the moment, Mugello felt like the rush hour periphery around Paris, didn't it?
Oh, and it's almost happened again there. Petrucci just sitting up on the exit of Biondetti 2. Will that cost Quartararo the place in P1?
Nothing between Quartararo's lap time in Sector 3 compared to Alex Rins. Now, Quartararo's found it a little bit difficult to get that Yamaha firing to top speed down this start finish trail. Has he found it this lap? No, not quite. Again, he loses time in sector four, but he's up to second place.
Get another lap at it. Rins is on another flyer as well. The Suzuki man has had a very good Friday, hasn't he?
got to say, Steve, this response from Alex Rins, he's coming into this Grand Prix under immense pressure, having had three successive no scores. The pressure's been ramped up. He knows that. Nobody knows it more than him. He apologised to his team for his latest mistake last time out in Le Mans, but what a response this has been from Alex Rins.
The chequered flag is out here then in the afternoon on Friday. Rins at the moment in P1. A good lap coming in from Franco Morbidelli as well on the Petronas Yamaha. Pirro as well. You can never discount Pirro from a top 10 appearance in Mugello.
You certainly can't. He knows this place like the back of his hand. Alex Rins then takes the chequered flag. Is he going to be on top spot? Because at the moment, there are late charges coming from the Yamahas. Two former teammates, Morbidelli and Quartararo, looking really strong. Morbidelli now on the slowest motorcycle in Mugello in FP2. Where's he going? Second.
That's
brilliant. Franco Morbidelli with a near 20-kilometre-an-hour deficit on the start-finish rate puts the Yamaha in second place. 46.331.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, he's on the slowest bike by 6 kilometres. The next slowest bike is 6 kilometres an hour faster than his at the moment. Brilliant from Morbidelli. Still time for it to change here. Bagnaia and Quartararo, the two men at the moment at the top of the World Championship on brilliant laps.
You can see how hard Quartararo was pushing there on board with him. Twitchy on the rear end as he flicked it into Biondetti 1. How much time did that cost him in this fourth sector? Bagnaia, estimated P3 for him. We're on board with El Diablo. Where's he going? Top three already. Can he improve? No. Checker flag's taken by the Frenchman. He stays third.
Bagnaia, though, he's got the power of the Ducati underneath him. Can he now challenge Alex Rins and the 146? Yes, he can. A 46.147. Bagnaia is going to top day one here at home on the Ducati in Mugello. Excellent last lap from him.
Yeah, picked up a tenth, Steve, in that last sector. That was all about getting the perfect line through Puccini, turn 15, to set himself up for the slingshot and the wind-up from third to sixth gear on that start-finish straight. Perfectly nailed that by Pekka Bagnaia. 46.147 then. It will be him that tops the session. And every single FP2 so far this year has been topped by a Ducati, and that record goes on.
Good session, that. All six different manufacturers inside the top 10. A very solid day for Red Bull KTM factory team. They'll be delighted with that first Friday.
Brilliant. He's just congratulating him on the birth of his daughter.
Lovely.
That's what a touch. What an absolutely top guy Pekka Bagnaia is.